training in Scotland, and we hadn't seen other people for weeks, months, and now here we are there, chatting, talking, laughing. It was a meeting I will never forget.
Finally, the two teams met up here at Spensbu for a feast. For gunner side, fresh reindeer meat. For grouse, treats brought from the UK.
Well, the chocolate and things that we hadn't tested for months. And we had reindeer stomach to give them. They didn't like it, so they didn't eat it. But we had meat, plenty of meat for them. We had a good meal that first night.
And of course they were very happy to have a feeling that now things are going to happen. So, no, it was a very, very happy meeting. And the next day we started work with paper and pencil and factory and operation in front of us.
On the eve of the operation, the 10 men relocated to this hut just a few miles from the factory. Between them and the target, there was a deep gorge spanned only by a narrow bridge. It was the obvious way in, but it was fortified, and trying to storm it could have spelled disaster.
Klaus Hellberg had lived here all his life, so he was the natural choice to do the recce and see whether this way in was practical.
I did not want to cross the bridge. There were German guards there with machine gun. Most of us thought it was too risky.
So Klaus started to think the unthinkable, a crossing place further down the gorge. It was completely unguarded, as the Germans never considered it to be a feasible way in.
I went down here in the middle of the day and tried to find a place where we could get down. It is very steep down here, and then cross the river and then up on the other side. And I did find quite a good place to get down, no difficulty at all. But this was in daytime, it was light, we had to do it in the darkness.
So after 4 months that had pushed survival skills to the limit, it all came down to this, 10 men against the atomic bomb. The night of the 27th of February 1943 would decide whether or not the men hiding inside this hut would halt Hitler's race to the bomb and give the Allies the crucial advantage.
It takes some time to get used to the idea that this is probably the last thing you do. But that's the difference, I think, to some extent, between people in the free world, I think, of Britain and America. You were never occupied. We knew what occupation was, and we fought against it, and we fought against it willingly. And so we moved towards Telemark.
Next on the Real Heroes of Telemark, we relive the incredible raid on the factory and tell of the saboteurs' amazing escapes to freedom.
I was hit by a hand grenade, but because he was just behind me and I ran so fast, so I was away. And then it exploded.
And as the Nazis rebuild the factory, a desperate new plan is hatched to end Hitler's quest for the atomic bomb.
The whole operation runs over a period of 2 years. And at every turn, the Germans are blighted by some of the greatest secret agents and special force members of special forces of the Second World War.